As the charming city of Dublin, also known as the Irish capital of Texas, puts final plans in place for its annual St. Patrick's celebration this weekend, we have a tasty twist to share with you, and it has to do with blending some of Dublin bottling works sodas with a soda...
Ology.
Say that again. Sodaology. Sodaology. I didn't know there was such a thing.
Yes.
It's so good to have you, Megan.
I'm glad to be here.
Tell me what the bottling works is, because I'm not familiar
with
that. Okay.
Dublin Bottling Works. It's our bottling plant in Dublin. Mm-hmm. We've been there since 1891, so going on 123 years, and we make our sodas with pure cane sugar.
So you make more than Dr. Pepper?
Well, we actually don't make Dr. Pepper anymore.
Oh, that's right. Y'all quit doing that.
So we make 11 different sodas, and we have them. They're all over the table right here.
I did not know that.
So we have anything from a cola to a peach to lemonade to orange.
And you are the expert on mixing them all together.
I am.
Well, show us how we can put these together.
The first one that we're going to do today is my favorite.
What is it?
It is our tart and sweet lemonade. So I'm going to make you one.
Tart and sweet lemonade.
Yes.
Are these non-alcoholic?
The ones in the bottles are non-alcoholic. But we are going to mix them with a little bit.
I got a little bit. Okay.
And so this is our tart and sweet lemonade, and it's mixed with a berry pucker.
A berry pucker.
Yes. And these are just local wines. You can get them at any liquor store.
Ah.
And so if you want to give it a try.
And these are your concoctions?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, and we worked on a project for Grumps. They wanted to sell sodas and mix them with... different liquors in their restaurant. Mm-hmm. So we came up with some that they can use.
This is really good. What do you call this?
We call it summer berry.
Summer berry.
Because your lemonade's in the summer.
Yeah, and you could be laying by the pool with your summer berry.
Exactly.
Yeah, okay. And I'm gonna hold this.
Okay, an alternative to some green beer is going to be, it turns green when you add.
Exactly.
So you
We're
can
ready.
Come have some green
What's next?
Sodas. Next, we have our vanilla cream. It's a very good one. Everybody at the plant loves it. And we're going to mix it with some basically peach schnapps.
Oh, wow.
Yes. All of our ladies at the soda shop, we love this drink.
I can see why. I bet it's delicious. Am
we'll
I going to taste that one too?
Yes. You can
good.
Try all you want.
What a great job I have. Okay, yeah. Really love that.
It is. Mm. It is a favorite.
Okay, that's good. Okay, keep drinking. What else?
Next one we have is our black cherry soda. Mm-hmm. And we're just going to mix it with some coconut rum. Black cherry is one of our new drinks. It came out last June, so it hasn't even been here for a year yet.
And you have the wonderful job of just playing with these all day and just making up concoctions.
I do.
That is so interesting.
It is one of my awesome hats I wear. Here we go.
Okay.
Let me know what you think about that one.
Oh, I like the black cherry.
Yes.
That's really tasty.
It is.
That's good. That's really good. Okay. I can't drink all of these or I'll have a problem.
I know. So. We can share.
We'll just make a little snack.
We'll share with everybody.
Okay.
This one is our orange cream soda. The orange cream, it's a slightly different from just an orange soda because it has that creamy taste. Mm-hmm. And we're going to mix it with some X-Rated. And it just turns out so good.
I like, what is X-Rated?
I think it has more of like a grapefruit taste to it, but I'm not
quite
sure.
Is it vodka or what?
It's a liqueur.
Liquor. Okay.
There we go. Try that one. Let me know what you think.
It's like high C.
Yes.
Okay, I like that too.
Yes.
You're really good. You're really good, Megan. I got a little stash going on right here. We got one left to make, right?
Yes, we do.
All right.
This is our vintage cola, which happens to be one of my favorite sodas that we just make at the plant.
I love the way you say my, because it's so Texan.
Thanks, it comes out every once in a while.
That's right.
And we're gonna mix it with a vanilla vodka that I brought.
All right. This is what again? Vintage
cola.
Vintage cola. All right.
And we'll give it a little stir.
Okay. Oh, you want to stir that. I was ready to go. Oh, I like the cola.
Yes.
Gotta love the cola.
Yeah, and it's perfect for just to have and take to the lake or whatever you
want
to do.
Oh my gosh, these are so fun. And what a different idea to do for the summer or the spring. Oh, that one didn't go there. I'm going to put all these back so everybody can see how beautiful you're.
Yes.
Now, can people still go on tours of the plant there?
You can. Yeah. This week we are open since it's spring break, Monday through Friday, as well as next week since St. Patrick's Day is Monday.
Awesome.
We're going to be open Monday through Friday, 10 to 5, and Saturday, 10 to 5, Sunday, 1 to 5.
Awesome. That'll be fun. And it's a great thing to do if you're doing staycation this week for spring break.
It is.
So it's a good thing to do. Thank you so much,
Megan.
You're a
delight.
You can join Dublin St. Patrick's celebration, which runs March 14th through the 15th. And on Saturday, especially, there will be all kinds of family fun. So head over to DublinTXChamber.com for more details and get yourself over there. Bring the babies. Coming up, Lucille Ball won our hearts years ago, and now we have her beloved antics taken center stage at Bass Performance Hall. We'll meet the actress who plays Ethel in this production, and you can bet she has some esplendid tutu. Stay with us.
Thank you so much.
This is